In this video, we're going to talk about macOS 10, 10.14 Mojave and a couple error messages that you might see that are related to a new security preference in the operating system. So you might see things like this error message here when you're trying to send an email from AccountEdge, or when you're trying to send a report to Excel or Microsoft Word, where it says not authorized to use to send Apple events. You might see one similar that references Excel. Now, the reason for that is because under when you went to use those features, a dialog came up that asked permission to use the Finder or use Excel or use Mail. And if you click Don't Allow, then the application doesn't have access to what it needs to actually perform those tasks. So if we go to System Preferences, you can see here I have AccountEdge listed and OfficeLink. OfficeLink is a piece of AccountEdge that allows you to work with Microsoft Office. And these boxes are unchecked. That means they don't have access, because AccountEdge uses Apple Script and Apple Events to create emails and send them to Mac Mail. And we also use Apple Script to use the Finder to launch Excel, and then we will use Excel and merge in data into an email template. Now, this new feature or this new preference is found under Privacy, in Security and Privacy, under Privacy, under a new section called Automation. What you're going to want to do is enter your username and password. This might take a little while to unlock, so you're going to have to be patient. I don't know why it takes this long. Okay, once it's unlocked, you check these boxes and you should be good to go. Okay, so let's get out of here. So we allowed access to these, and I'm going to show you what those dialogs look like. So first, what I'm going to do is I'm going to clear these out as if we never allowed access to the applications, and we're going to do this again. So I'm going to go into AccountEdge, and we're going to send a report to Excel, and we'll do that, send it to Excel, and you'll see that it says, hey, the OfficeLink processor wants access to control the Finder. And that's because we use the Finder, we use Apple Script to then launch Microsoft Excel. So you want to make sure you click OK, because if you say not OK, then in that preference in security and privacy, you're going to have to go in and check the box. Second dialog comes up saying, hey, OfficeLink wants access to Excel. You have to say OK, otherwise we can't put the data into the template. So you want to click OK. And again, once you do that, and you go over to System Preferences, Security and Privacy, and you'll see Excel and Finder are now listed here. Lastly, like we were talking about before, if you wanted to send an email, we'll choose Send Email. You'll get a message that says AccountEdge wants access to Mail to control the application, because we need to launch the app, and then we actually need to create an email and stick it into the outbox. If you click Don't Allow again, it's going to show up in the preference with the box unchecked. So that's fine. Email was sent out. Now, if we go over to System Preferences, you'll see now Mac Mail is listed. You might see in here Microsoft Outlook. You might see other applications. You might see Microsoft Word listed here. But again, if you clicked Don't Allow, you're going to need to come in here and check these boxes in order for the application to use it. Now, I will mention that if you did click Not Allow, and then you came here and you checked this box, you probably will need to quit Mail before you actually send another email out of AccountEdge, because Mac Mail will be in a state where it's still blocking the email, and you'll still get the same message. So just go up to Mail, quit it, come back to AccountEdge, and run it, and you should be good to go. All right, so those are the changes that have to do with security and privacy. And again, you can find them in Automation. This is new to macOS 10, 10.14 Mojave, and how it works with other applications, so that you are asked if you want to allow other applications to control the Finder or other applications like Microsoft Excel. And I hope that's helpful.